Good afternoon. Most of you know me as Dr. Andrew Michaels. Today we're going to do some research. Don't worry, my friend. I'm here to help you.
Just an Irish lullaby.
What I have before us today is very rare. Very rare. Now I know that this object looks like something from Mars Attacks. I want to handle it gently. Looks like it looks like a gonad fell off someone during the filming of Mars Attacks. But I assure you, this is a terrestrial fruit. It is. It's very heavy. Very heavy. And this fruit is called an Osage orange. Like brains. Is that where they got the idea for Mars Attacks? I've always thought that. It's just beautiful. They're just gorgeous. In Ohio, we call them monkey balls. That's what we call them. And I love every fall playing with some monkey balls. It resembles a citrus fruit, but it is not citrus at all, even though it does have vitamin C. It is more closely related to, I believe, the mulberry. See how it has these little alien hairs on it, little threads. It's the most beautiful flower in the spring, and then it grows into this gnarly fruit, the megafauna of North America used to partake of it, but they are long gone, and now it is here for us to study, to observe. You almost think if you put on a stethoscope, you might hear an alien heartbeat. Such a unique fruit. grow more readily in the South, in Texas, Oklahoma, Arkansas. But they do grow as far north as Ohio, Virginia, Pennsylvania. A lot of people like to put them in their basements to ward off spiders. But this has not been scientifically proven. But people do think that they can ward off spiders. I don't know what I think. Do enjoy every fall probing the secrets of the Osage Orange. See the little threads on them. Oh, how interesting they are. The little follicles of the flower. I've got my monkey balls. I'm kind of hoping somebody down south, Southern ASM artist, will go out and get some monkey balls of their own and show me what they can do with an Osage Orange. So alien. So strange. Free, cheap, and fun prop. They smell good. And I like to rub them. Thank you. that sounds. mine was fun. I had so much fun. I got to do a lot of fun things with my family. And not only did I do fun things with my family, I also made some extra money. And I'm hoping I can get a new piece of equipment by the end of the month. Christmas is coming. It's getting very exciting. After Halloween, it's a mad rush from Halloween all the way up till Christmas. Isn't it? As the great Louis Anderson used to say, I have the sweater, I'll explode. Sage orange that I've brought to you today. Do you like it? Do you enjoy it? Isn't it cool? I love how it looks on camera. It's so beautiful. So absolutely gorgeous. It's wonderful. I love the sounds the sap make on the vinyl gloves, and I wish I could bring the smell to you. Almost citrus, but not. It's weird. And I forgot. I want to mention this young man who was really nice and mentioned me in a video. Smart ASMR. Really nice young man. I'm going to do it here at the end so that near the end of the video. Smart ASMR. Seemed like a really nice young man, very calm, very good spirit, and he does really nice videos, and he's just starting out, and he was nice enough to shout me and two other artists out. I hope you'll take the time to go to Smart ASMR. I'll put a link below, and maybe you could subscribe or just say hello to him and tell him TR sent you, and I think it would be a nice way to welcome him into this glorious community that has so many very nice people and only a few people, you know, that don't know how to play well with others. I was very blessed early on to meet a lot of nice folks who helped me grow and help my channel. And, you know, you always have to remember the good people and the nice people. And this Smart ASMR is a nice young man. And I want people to go and check his channel out. He does very simple videos. Right now he's learning. He's building his craft. And, you know, there's another one too I want to mention next time. Alf, I don't know how to say his name. TR, you don't know how to say that guy's name. Alpheus ASMR or something. He's a very nice young man. And these guys are going to be players down the road, I think. Maybe. And they deserve a chance. We all deserve a chance. Everybody deserves to be spoken well of when you do good things and you are good to people. You should get treated well back. And the same goes for bad people. When somebody's a rotten prick, we should remember that karma has a way of balancing the scales without very much help from us. At least that's what I think. Yes, karma is an amazing thing. An amazing thing. So, we have today monkey balls. Fun to play with. We have talked about Smart ASMR and how nice a young man he is, and another nice young man named Alpheus ASMR. And I'll talk about him again some other time. He didn't do a shout out, but I just like his style. I like what these young men are doing something, and they're learning. And they're doing it their own way. And I like that. I think that's cool. I don't like a lot of tapping. But I love when Ghetto ASMR or Mikolas does a lot of tapping. They've got it, a style. They've got a knack to it. And I admire their skill. And I think they're both drummers. And that probably has a lot to do with it. They have a rhythm and a beat and a musical feel, a sensation to their tapping. It's not just randomness. It's got a, you know, a beat to it. And I don't know if they set the beat themselves. You know, I don't know if that's something they do. Today, because a lot of times I mention a lot of the female artists because they treat me so well. But today we want to talk about just some of these guys, and it's hard for guys, and they struggle. You know, they struggle to get the views and the attention that a lot of the ladies get somewhat automatically, because as soon as a pretty girl pops up, a lot of times the guys will, you know, share her channel. So I don't think the guys get talked about as much, which is okay, because I think the guys, it pushes them. I've talked about this with friends. I think it pushes the creativity of the male artists to go further, to try harder than they would if it came easy to them. I think a lot of the guys will experiment more. They'll do role plays that are crazy and weird, and I mean, I do crazy weird role plays. We do that because we're pushing our craft. You know, we're pushing it. We have to push it. We have to push the boundaries of ASMR out, or we're left behind. We lose our audience. They go away. And that's the honest truth. They just often vanish. So, and that's something else I want to talk about. I've been in this for a while now, and your audience does turn over. So if you're frustrated and your views are going down and you can't figure it out and everything doesn't seem to be working like it used to, YouTube has a huge turnover, so you have to bring new people into your audience. You have to reach out to new artists. You have to reach out to new people. You have to constantly reinvent yourself as an artist. You've got to keep pushing those boundaries. You got to keep you got to go back and do those videos in the past that were popular and put new spins on them. You know, you can't be sedentary. You've got to be fluid with your artwork. You've got to keep going and do something new every time. That's what keeps us going. That's what renews your audience. And you have to strike out and make new friends and get people to talk about you. If people don't talk about you, if they're not talking about you, sharing your work, you ain't gonna make it. You ain't gonna make it. You're just gonna wither and die. So, if you get a chance, stop by Smart ASMR's channel and subscribe and check them out. Give them a chance. Give them a chance. If we give them a chance, maybe they can do something with their craft. And the other artist is Alpheus ASMR. I probably butchered his name. But he's a very nice young man. They're both very nice young men. Let's throw some good words and good vibes their way. And help them get some subscribers and some views and a little bit of attention. And, you know, don't be afraid to go to your favorite artist today, no matter who they are, male, female, whoever, and share their work. There's places you can share on your social media. There's Reddit. There's all kinds of places. Let's do a good turn today. If you're watching this and you've been a longtime subscriber, let's share a friend. Let's share someone's video with somebody and help them grow a little bit. That might be something kind we can do for each other today. And that'd be kind of cool. That's something neat we can do. As the holidays are coming up, let's put something back into ASMR for getting so many good things out of it. How's that sound? That actually sounds like a pretty cool idea. Okay. All right. So, I'm going to leave you now, and I want to thank you so much for coming here today. I love each and every one of you with all my heart. You make me keep going. You do. You make me keep going with your love and your caring and your understanding, your kind comments, and I love talking to all of you in the comment section. I know I can't comment to every single one, but I try to reach out to as many of you as I can. Okay? And I'm going to keep doing that. This is a team effort. You and me. Alright? And until I see you again, please, please, have a most blessed day. Alright?